In corporate stories, AT&T has dropped HBO Max as a bundle perk for new customers on its highest tier unlimited wireless plan. AT&T still owned WarnerMedia when it launched HBO Max in 2020, so it could offer subscriptions with no extra charge, but it has since been sold to Discovery. Amazon is closing its gig economy delivery service in Germany. The e-commerce giant's Flex program, which began in the U.S. in 2015 before expanding to Germany 2 years later, pays drivers to ferry packages in their own vehicles from Amazon warehouses to customers' homes. And bad news for Apple. The European Union is set to require a single charger for all smartphones to combat electronic waste. The move could force iPhones to use the USB-C charger by 2024. The Philippine Trade Department vows to time price increases of basic commodities accordingly so as not to burden consumers too much. The agency is currently studying requests from at least three manufacturers, including bread makers, to raise the cost of their products.
The request is actually at 4 pesos, and what they say is to grant them the 2 pesos now and then 2 pesos maybe a month later under the administration of Secretary Pascual. But we're still reviewing it. This is only for Pinoy Tasty and Pinoy Pandesal. This is the special brand of bread that is made by the Phil Baking. It's an association of big bread manufacturers. We do not want businesses to fold. When they stop producing the products that we regulate, these are the products that are lowest priced and the most affordable in the market, the consumers will have no choice, will not have that choice anymore. That's why we're also helping the businesses.
As the prices of other staple goods go up, the Agrarian Reform Department meanwhile proposes a plan to bring down the price of rice to just 20 pesos per kilo, as promised by President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr.
Kaya po ang tinignan natin is the traditional way nung kung paano natin pinuproduce yung palay ngayon, talaga hong napaka-imposible. Kung maiayos lang po siguro natin na tama, mamomodernize natin yung ating pagtatanim at gagamitan natin ng magagandang binhi, yung mga bagong teknolohiya, yun po ay talagang mapapababa natin yung cost of production.
For outgoing Agriculture Chief William Dar, bringing down rice prices to 20 pesos per kilo is not doable for now. Dar says rice prices in the Philippines remain high due to high cost of production. He also notes fertilizer prices have tripled since the start of the Russian invasion of Ukraine. To ensure higher production, Dar says he requested for more funding for fertilizers this year.
Papadagdag tayo, additionally 6 billion pesos para mayroon tayong ibibigay itong wet season planting na 9 billion pesos para ma-sustain if not increase the level of production that we have in this country. Mm. Yung 3 billion ay nandyan na, ay, ito na yung kinakasa namin ibibigay. Yung 6 billion, yun ang nire-request natin for consideration by the President and the DBM.
A group of bus drivers commissioned by the government to give free rides decry the backlogs in their salary. The group says transport authorities did not deliver on their promised weekly payout. It questions the statement of Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board Chairman Martin Delgra when he said the funds for the program were already disbursed.
Yung iba pong mga kasamahan namin, siyempre po hindi naman po pwede na tumigil. Talaga pong may naghanap na dyan ng mga ikabubuhay para sa pamilya. At meron din po talaga na kung saan-saan na lumalapit at ang mabigat po, yung iba, yung mga nangungupahan, ay pinalalayas na po sa tirahan kasi hindi nga po makabayad.
Local oil player Petrogas implements a price rollback for its diesel products. Over 100 of the company's gas stations nationwide have slashed diesel prices by 3 pesos and 50 centavos. The price cut will be in effect until Saturday, June 11th. Fuel prices here in the Philippines have more than doubled since 2020 after hefty price hikes this year. The Energy Department, however, said it does not see gas and diesel prices hitting 100 pesos per liter this year.